Sadly, you're as useful to me now as a backstage pass to Limp Bizkit.
Why are certain genres, like rap metal, so universally hated? I'm kinda sick of being aggravated. I'm glad I'm hated. I guess I'm doing something right. Well, my friend, for the answer, we must head down under. Australians came up with the term cultural cringe to describe a certain inferiority the Australian people felt in relation to their contemporaries. The British had a long, rich history to stand on, and the Americans, while not being around nearly as long, have made quite a name for themselves and have replaced Britain as the world's superpower. By comparison, anything Australia attempted to do seemed like a little brother copying his older sibling with mediocre results. This made the Australians feel lesser, as if they were the poor man's Britain or discount America. To make matters worse, Australians literally descended from a prison colony, so they also carry the shame of being the descendants of convicted criminals. As a cultural narrative, this is quite a blow. It certainly doesn't have the heroic triumph of 1776. America dominated the world, and part of America's identity is the anti-British sentiments it won its independence on. However, this attitude has shifted over time to be more generally adversarial to the history of white peoples in general, white men in particular. I believe this has instilled cultural cringe in the white men that inhabit Americanized cultures. They don't want their culture, they want another. You can see this cultural cringe in Korea and Japan as well. K-pop is influenced by American pop music, and anime and other Japanese culture is very German influenced. We now have super meta hyper real insane things happening, like the strange case of Ollie London, who aspires to be like the K-pop star, Jimin. So we have a British man pretending to be a Korean man, pretending to be an American pop star. Western people are also experiencing cultural cringe over their terrible comic, television, and film industry, opting instead to be interested in the Japanese manga and anime. We have a strange phenomenon where we have Anglo-Saxon American men whose first and perhaps only introduction to the classic German tragedy Faust is through a Japanese animation about magical girls. This is a bizarre scenario we are in, where people end up rediscovering their own cultures through other cultures, since they are both experiencing cultural cringe at the same time. We have a highly Americanized world. I believe that in this world, stemming from exaggerated British hatred, white men opt to identify as something other than what they are, usually American women or African Americans. Imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, they say. I believe this is best represented by glam metal and rap metal, the most hated metal genres. Glam metal, also known as hair metal by normies, is a fusion of classic heavy metal and glam rock that was popular in the 1980s. Thematically, it is a satirization of American women. The band members were almost always men who dressed excessively feminine. It is not that dissimilar to drag queen culture, which may also be a manifestation of cultural cringe. It is a parody of the feminine, capturing mostly just the superficial, the hair and makeup, hence the name hair metal and glam metal. The lyrical themes are almost 100% of the time about sex. And sure, you could say that is the main motivation for most rock music, if not just most music in general, but here it's hard to dig two syllables into the lyrics without finding a euphemism for something dirty. As I said, it is a caricature of the American female. It is possibly the most vapid and superficial type of music. It may occasionally get surface level deep, with the odd ballad here and there, which discusses things like heartbreak, but honestly, the entire genre is one giant shitpost. Bands of the genre include Motley Crue, Poison, and Rat. And don't get me wrong, if you like the music, you like the music. There's nothing wrong with enjoying vapid and superficial things from time to time. It's pop music, it's fun, I get it. I just think it's interesting to ponder why this style emerged and gained popularity when it did, and what it says about our culture. We are right to cringe thinking back on it. But remember, cultural cringe, spawned it to begin with. If I am to steel man this genre, I would be remiss if I did not mention Alice in Chains. They are generally thought of as a grunge band, but I don't entirely agree with that categorization. There is a subgenre called sleaze, yes, that's a real thing, best attributed to Guns N' Roses, which is a fusion of glam metal and hard rock. I believe Alice in Chains owes a lot more to them sound-wise than Nirvana. Hell, even the name is similar. Alice in Chains is a hybrid of sleaze and grunge, being very much the hangover after the party that was the 80s. Their lyrics delved into dark topics such as addiction and alienation. So if you want some glam metal that has some depth to it, I highly recommend the album Dirt. Just listen to Down in a Hole. There is true beauty and authenticity here. It is the morning after. It is the 90s. The makeup has smeared, and the hair has been disheveled. Man must face his true self. Jumping ahead later into the decade, and into the early 2000s, we have rap metal. At this point, the gender swapping is getting old. So why not try race swapping? As a response to the embarrassing humiliation that was the gender-bending boomers desperately trying to get laid, the following generation decided to do a 180 and go hyper-masculine. If the theme of glam metal is exaggerated femininity, the theme of rap metal is exaggerated masculinity. It's try-hard, it's edgy, it's big Chad energy. Despite the fact rap metal's main demographic was 8th grade millennial kids that look like Guy Fieri. This wannabe tough guy ghetto attitude is based off African American culture, and much like the former genre, it feels like a giant caricature. There may be a little more depth to it lyrically than glam metal, but that's a really low bar. To steel man once more, I'd say Slipknot is the best the genre has to offer. Much like Alice in Chains, there are a mix of styles though, this time combining rap metal with nu metal, groove metal, and alternative metal. All Hope Is Gone is probably their best album. To bring this video full circle, their song Gematria discusses America colonizing the world. If I had to make a prediction of what our current decade will bring, it is a polarization. On one hand, we will see art and music which reflects authentic masculinity and European history. And on the other, we will perhaps see the ultimate rejection of identity, the reverence of the soulless automaton, completely gender neutral, the peak cultural cringe. I hope you now see the meaning behind these genres. Join me next time, where I will discuss another. Be sure to like, subscribe, share, whatever. And until next time, ask yourself, what's in a meme? Put your hands into his side. Can't pick up a boulder with relative ease. His coconut gum can fire and spurs. If he shoots up, it's gonna hurt. So the finally here, peanuts, pineapple smell.